What's good? It was good, y'all. It's your girl Nasirah Sky, and I am back with another video. So today's get ready with me chit chat video. You guys will see how I wash my face with falsies on, cause I don't like taking them on and off. It's just like much. How I wash my face, brush my teeth, and then I'm gonna bring you guys back to my room where I want to talk about Black Lives Matter. Let's go. So right now y'all want to see me wash my face, brush my teeth. Y'all know the vibes. That's just what it is. Hey you guys, so I'm back. Okay, so right now I'm going to show you guys how I do my hair. I don't know why, but I like to straighten my hair before I crimp it. People still can notice this on my phone. So y'all know I like to deal with the lace first and then the hair, so let's begin. Get into how I feel about Black Lives Matter once I'm done with the lace and I can concentrate. Okay, I could fix over here, but this side, yeah, I could do a little 1, 2, 3. Y'all, I'm looking hurt on camera. It's okay. It's alright. Okay. What do I want to do? But I had a lot of people that encouraged me after I found out about my content being deleted and stuff. And I want to say thank you to those people. Everybody knows how passionate I am about my channel, my content, everything. Like, I want to, basically, I'm saying people that's doing YouTube for the wrong reasons, don't film me. But if you see me looking up here, I have a mirror right here. I forgot to tell you guys that. I don't know why, but this side is just, like, so freaking aggravating. It probably looks mad weird on camera, not gonna lie. But in person, it looks mad natural, like. In person, it looks dumb natural. Y'all see how dedicated I am to getting content to you guys? One of my dreams, like, y'all already know, one of my dreams is to become a successful entertainer. Y'all know I go to an HBCU, and a lot of things that's happening right now with the Black Lives Matter, everybody has their own beliefs on it, their own opinions on it. Let's talk about mine. Now, I don't want nobody to think that I'm coming for them, a particular group, or, you know, I'm just saying how I feel. How I feel is what I'm saying. Yeah, I just want to say that everybody has an opinion that they're entitled to, whether you agree or you don't agree. But yeah, I'm gonna need y'all to click that bell after y'all subscribe so y'all can get notified for when I upload the hair reinstall video, because trust me, that video is going to help your life. Like, if you don't know how to braid your own scalp, or even if you don't feel like braiding your own scalp, I don't have a flat iron, but I use Beauty Labs brush iron. Y'all know y'all gotta start from the bottom. Sometimes I'll be forgetting, whatever. But yeah, let's talk about this Black Lives Matter. I don't even know where to start. Y'all know I'm a criminal justice major. I always wanted to be an attorney of the law. So with that being said, I had lost interest in becoming an attorney because I felt like I lost my passion for it. Like, I'm like, I don't know if that's really what I wanna do. I found my passion in, you know, elsewhere, like, like entertainment, modeling, fashion, you know? So that's where I found my passion, you know, YouTube and stuff like that. So I'm like, I wanna be an entrepreneur, like, you know? My major is still criminal justice and not business management, marketing, it's none of that. It's communications, I kept my major as criminal justice because I knew that that's really what I'm interested in. Even if I don't end up becoming an attorney, that is where my passion is. Like, I love learning about the law, I love contemplating, I love learning about cases, I love doing all of that. So I stuck with criminal justice as my major. I wasn't too sure if I wanted to pursue it, as I said. I wasn't too sure. I didn't know if I wanted to go the legal studies track or if I wanted to just, after college, just be done, like, with school. Like, that's what I wanted to do at the moment. Yeah, so up until I saw this video, y'all already know what's going on right now with the riots and the looting and etc. I saw this video of a woman, and she basically had her face smashed in the concrete by male cops, and it's just like, for no reason, like, honestly, for no reason. One, they're not, cops are not even reading Miranda rights anymore. Like, they're not reading Miranda rights. You can ask them why they are arresting you. Like, what is their probable cause? You can ask them that. And they won't tell you, they just violate your rights. So, I actually cried watching that video, honestly. And I couldn't get any sleep at night because they just really, like, for what? Like, for what? I'm gonna see if I can link it down below for you guys that do want to see it, but I was very moved, and that just made me realize, well, it just gave me, I don't know, like I said, I lost my passion for law, but it just gave me a perspective that we need more lawyers of color. Like, we need more highly intelligent lawyers and stuff, so that stand for stuff. And basically, I want to go to law school after I graduate from the first degree granted HBCU, Lincoln University. I still don't share L, you know. So yeah. And another thing I want to tell a lot of influencers. I know that a lot of influencers just want to be doing YouTube, but they also, like, don't know if they want. I know this is kind of trash. Probably because I'm running it through kind of fast. That's why I say, y'all, I don't know. I just start talking, and then everything I'm saying is just like. But, yeah, you could do YouTube and become whatever you want to become. Like me. I wanted to own my own law firm and, of course, be an attorney, a defense attorney. But I want to do more. Like, I want my own law firm to be dedicated to helping those who were wrongfully convicted, whose rights were violated, you know. And I also want to help certain families that can't afford, you know, a good attorney. Like, and to keep the money flow, I still plan on having my own businesses. I want to get into real estate. I want to do everything. And you could do everything with your life. Like, trust me, you guys. Yesterday, I was saying a lot about what I've learned that a lot of people don't know about. Like, I was saying that me and my friend Maya was having this back and forth, which I love debating with my friends, but I love my friends who are very vocal like me, opinionated like me, and they don't follow what the majority thinks or the majority says. So we was having a conversation about whether a HBCU is better than a PWI, and I get asked these questions a whole lot. So hold that thought, I'm gonna revisit that topic. A lot has to be done. I understand why people are protesting, but I understand why people are looting too. Like, I understand it, of course, but it also gets to a point where you're destroying your own neighborhood that you have to live in. Workers of our skin tone are cleaning up the mess that you left. If y'all wanna loot, y'all wanna do that, do it, for me, by all means. As long as the cause for everything that you're doing benefits your people. Corporations are supporting racist white supremacists. It's much bigger than that, okay? People are out there marching for their kids, their grandkids, the now. You feel me? Like, it's just, why y'all didn't remind me to plug this up? But it's cool, it gets hot fast. But yeah, y'all, maybe I'll take this time right now to go through messages. But y'all, it's crazy out here, man. That's just what I decided to do with my life. So I have a whole plan what I want to do. So while I'm in college, learning about my major and, you know, taking my major classes and whatnot, what I also will be doing is my YouTube channel. So I want to do YouTube throughout my whole, like, college, law school, and I also want to start my businesses while I'm in law school and stuff like that, doing what I need to do to pass my bar exams. And then once I pass my bar exam, hopefully I have enough funding from my businesses to get my own office where I can start, you know, helping my people. And that's pretty much, you know, and it won't be too hard actually to find, like, somebody who's been brutalized by police or stuff like that, because nowadays social media is a heavy platform where nothing can hide, like, nothing. So right now I'm chatting, but I'm about to look for me and my friend Maya conversation. But also I want to let you guys know that today is Thursday, June 4th, so by the time I put this video out, I don't know what's gonna be happening. I don't know what's gonna transition. I don't know the future, because right now when you guys are seeing this, it is the future. This is a pre-recorded video, so I'm saying right now, June 4th, what's happening, okay? Because I can't speak on the future. I don't know, but I'm about to show y'all. I found it. So she basically posted, let me show you guys so you know I'm not lying, Maya. Shout out to you, boo. But before we get into that, let me show y'all. So this is the bedhead one. Oh, okay. It burned through my table. So this is the bedhead one. I actually ordered 2 crimp irons on accident. This one is really cute. This one is so little and it's so cute. Like, what? So little, so cute. Yes. So my mother actually used that one already. This one, the small one, and she liked it. So that's good. But yeah, let me tell y'all. So basically, I ordered the bedhead one, but my Amazon likes to switch from my college address to my home address by itself. So I thought I ordered it home, but it actually went to Lincoln. But Lincoln emailed me. I didn't think that anybody was gonna be in the mailroom. So once Lincoln emailed me and they're like, yeah, we have a package for you, can we send it to your address? And I'm like, what? Wow. If I would have known y'all was doing that, I would have ordered that one from Walmart. So anyways, that's just a little back thingy thing, whatever. A little background of why I have 2 crimp irons. But I'm gonna use a little one, like, on a go, like if I'm going on vacation or something like that. Let's get into this. Is a HBCU better than a PWI conversation? And basically, I'll be basically summing up everything that we said. So her point was educationally wise, PWIs are better. What the fuck? Is my finger weak? Okay. So she has said something on her, well, she has shared something on her story where it said, oh, I recommend everybody attend a, ooh, I just burned myself. I'm gonna burn my tattoo off. But yeah, I recommend everybody attend the HBCU. And she said something about you can get the same education or something like that, which is understandable that one might think that way. So I texted back and I said, damn, I don't wanna burn myself. Hold on, y'all. I texted back and I said, I honestly agree with this because you get a different experience from attending the HBCU and the PWI. At an HBCU, everyone is united, including the professors. Oh yeah, they set you up to win and they give you chances due to the fact that they know that the system is set up to be against us, right or wrong. Everybody that attends the HBCU knows this. So then she said, oh wait, and I said, when I went to a PWI, it was cool, but I didn't get the same type of education. Let me explain that point. When I was 11th grade, I had gotten a scholarship to attend Syracuse University. Is that it? Yeah, Syracuse University. And I basically was still a high school student, but for the summer, I was taking college courses, which I got college credit from. And I was living on campus then for a month. And and I was living on campus and stuff. I was an actual college student for the summertime. So basically you could say I got both experiences from a PWI and a HBCU. So then she said, I agree with what you're saying 100%, but I feel like that is exactly why PWIs are better educational wise. She said, yes, it feels nice to be surrounded by amazing and successful African Americans that know the system is made to be put against, but I don't know if Buff counts. She used to attend Buffalo State, upstate New York, but now she's focusing on her business. So that's where she's talking from. She said she don't know if Buffalo State counts. And she said, but those white teachers pushed me and taught me beyond what I would ever thought, honestly. When I went to North Carolina in the summer and visited Shaw JSC, and whew, I had fun and all. But she said, but she wasn't feeling very challenged in the classroom. That's fine, you feel me? Like, HBCUs are not for everybody. Like, I'm not about to, like, sit here and bash your head open because you didn't attend an HBCU. Because I know a lot of people that attend an HBCU that I'm cool, I mean, a PWI that I'm cool with, and it's like, I'm not about to bash their head in because they want to attend a PWI, you feel me? But I do recommend everybody to attend a HBCU because you learn the truth about your history, you learn the truth about laws, you learn the truth about your rights. So, let me continue and read for you guys. So, when she said that, I said, nah, I get where you're coming from. Hold on, let me lock this. That's the good thing about bedhead. You could lock it closed so you don't have to like keep like, you feel me? But I said, nah, I get where you're coming from, but especially specifically at Lincoln, you do get challenged in every aspect because they know once we go outside of campus, we're going to be challenged physically, we're going to be challenged mentally, we're going to be challenged racially, we're going to be challenged in every aspect. So Lincoln prepared you for that. If you guys don't know, I actually chose going to Lincoln University over going to Clark Atlanta University, and a lot of people was like trying to come, like was trying to like understand like why would you do that, like you know Clark, I don't attend school. Yes, I attend school to be happy and, you know, hang out and stuff. But I honestly felt like Lincoln was the place for me. It's not too big. It's a very small school. It's a family. And that's what I'm looking for. So that's what I got. And I love Lincoln. I do not regret my choice 1,000 times over. So I said, when I attended Syracuse. Oh, wait. I said, but people are there to help. When I attended Syracuse, it wasn't the same. I'd much rather everyone attend an HBCU. Then I said, you learn about our history, chattel slavery, finding flaws in the 13th Amendment, and etc. A lot of people don't even know what chattel slavery means. Like, a lot of people think the 13th Amendment really abolished slavery. Sweetheart, what I want you to do when you finish watching this video, go and Google the 13th Amendment. Find the loophole that they kept our people enslaved, justified it using the 13th Amendment, sweetheart. people don't know that, which is why I say go to HBCU so you know your history, you know how we're still being enslaved. The laws that's trying to be used to protect us, all they do is justify our enslavement. So then I said, take it from a person that attended a PWI, had professors from there, living the college life on campus, and etc. Being around a whole bunch of white people at Syracuse. Come on. Y'all know upstate, that's what there is. And I said, in attending an HBCU and living the college life and having professors. Literally, at Lincoln, everyone has a 3.0 or higher, bro. Like, and I said, education-wise, HBCUs are where it's at, period. Like, period. Especially at the first degree granted, HBCU Lincoln University. I did a whole paper on institutions, white institutions, and black institutions. Let me know if y'all want me to talk more about this topic, because I'm really open to talking about it. Like I said, I'm a criminal justice major. This is what my focus is. She said, I didn't mean to say Shaw earlier. It actually was a really good school, but yes, I agree. I love having friends that I can have conversations like this with, which is true. Shout out to Maya. I love you, boo, and I love you for having your own opinion. And I'm not trying to change it. And I'm also a Scorpio, so we're very opinionated, and we believe that we're always right because we are always right. No shade. But I'm not about to like sit here like argue her head off about it. But I just want her to see why her point of you get a better education at a PWI is false. Take it from somebody that got education from both. Let me talk a little about the classes that I took in Syracuse so you guys know where I'm coming from. In Syracuse, I took a law class and a business class because those are my two focuses. I took both classes. I took my cyber law class, right? And in a law class, you're supposed to learn about the laws and stuff like that, right? The laws that were created, why they were created. But cyber law class, it focused more on like copyrights and stuff like that. If you want to learn about your history, if you really truly care, if you want to see how history is repeating itself, slavery really never left, attend an HBCU. You're gonna learn, like. But I can't speak for every HBCU and I can't speak for every white institution. I would have never thought I would have learned so much about our history, and it's very heartbreaking. Go and watch the film The 13th. White people saw us as savages, as hunters, as uneducated, as animals. I just encourage everybody to learn about your history. Educated, please. Please just be educated before you want to put statements out there about the police brutality that's happening. That's all I can say. Just try to go educate yourself. If y'all wanna, okay, so my social medias will be in the description down below. If y'all wanna talk more about this and get more educated, we can have a whole conversation. If y'all disagree with my opinion and y'all wanna learn more of why I'm saying what I'm saying of stuff like this, y'all, we can have a whole conversation about this. Like, honestly, because I'm passionate about this. This is my passion. It took me a while to realize that, but better late than never. I think my purpose, I don't even think my purpose, I know my purpose is to help people. So I don't know if I mentioned it, but I want my practice to also help those who can't afford it, but still were wrongfully treated in the whole process of their indictment, of their arrest, anything. All right, y'all, so I'm done with the first side. How y'all think I did? This is day two of me learning how to do it. My mother actually had to come in here when I first used it and teach me how to do it because I was so freaking lost, like. But yeah, I'm gonna try to get my energy up for y'all because I feel like this whole video has just been a little down. Yeah. Comment down below how y'all feel about Black Lives Matter. So how do you guys feel about somebody saying Black Lives only matter when it's white people killing us? When I shared it, a lot of people asked me like, oh, you agree with this? Like, but I really shared it to see like who would disagree and why they would disagree. We didn't just wake up and just start killing each other. Like, where y'all think it stemmed from? I just inhaled all the smoke and that's bad for you. But yeah, y'all, why keep inhaling the smoke? I'm forever grateful and appreciative to those who send positivity my way, because a lot of people know how passionate I am about anything in life that I really want to do. So yeah, if y'all supporting me, I want to say thank you guys for supporting me. I truly appreciate it. I put the got to be so it could like stick, like the curls could be just like much better. Now when I crimp iron my hair, I just watch YouTube videos and stuff. Like, I don't really do too much. I just do stuff that keeps me entertained while I do this. I don't even have nothing on my lips, so if my lips look kind of dry, excuse it. I have a lot of college vlogs coming for you guys, a lot of vlogs and BK coming for you guys. Like, we outside, like, that's not on that. We outside and the gang is single. Oh, it's lit, like, it's lit. Y'all know my body, y'all know my vibe. Let me know if y'all want me to start doing pranks. I can't, because the people that I'll be pranking do too much. I'll probably prank other people though when I get to college. I have a whole lot of planned videos to do when I go to college. So y'all just hit the bell and subscribe so y'all can see the lit ass content. Support is free. All you gotta do is just click the button, subscribe. Why haven't they found Pop Smoke Killer? Like, that whoever killed him is still roaming free. Like, what y'all think that was the inside job though? Like, I don't know. People are envious though, and y'all really killed a good ass artist. Like, y'all killed, he was an artist, he was a son, he was a boyfriend, he was a father. Like, he was an uncle. He was, well, I don't know if he was an uncle. Well, he could have been an uncle. You feel me? Like, he was a human being, bro. Like, y'all really, yo, whoever killed him, karma's gonna come for them. No cap. And karma's gonna be way worse than any other punishment. Cause karma has no rules. Well, it has rules, but y'all know what I'm talking about. Like, it don't have no boundaries. Karma is gonna go crazy. And everybody was saying how they love my crunch yesterday. Let's see if they come out just the same or better. I hope they come out better. Now the front piece, I'll be putting OD because I need this piece to look bad. Like, the front piece is what people really be seeing. If y'all know me, I'm very independent and I don't like asking for stuff. Like this video if you just the same. And I'm gonna redo the living dormant with your best friend pro and con, and I'm gonna have my best friend in it. So y'all could see from both points of views. She probably is not gonna see no con, because it's really not really a con with us. But I know it could be different for other best friends. Hey y'all, you know what I don't like? Just a little rant. I don't like how you gotta buy new AirPods every 3 months. What's tea? Because listen, I'm not about to keep spending $200 for new AirPods every 3 months, y'all. Like, that's not the way. Like, and also, how y'all feel about Trina and what she said? Comment down below. Like, y'all still supporting sis? Like, what? I feel like everybody is entitled to their opinion, right? But it gets to a certain extent. Like, it gets to a certain extent where it's like, okay, now you sound ignorant. Like, okay, now, like, what? You're what? What she just said? Nah. It gets to like, what? Like when you say stupid shit and you offend people, that's where the line crosses. Like, what? And you know what we fighting for, and you over here saying, oh well, I have my license and registration. Like, you don't think the people that got killed by the police don't have their license and registration either? Like, sis, what? I don't know. I'm not feeling what she said though, so I'm not feeling Doja Cat. I'm not feeling Who else? Tokyo Jets. Cause sis, referencing George Floyd's name as a joke, choking your friend was cool. Canceled. Doja Cat saying nigger and all this other racist shit she was saying, canceled. Like, a whole lot of people are canceled in my opinion. When I say my points of views and my statements, I'm not just coming from a place of my people. You guys, if you don't know, I will show you my diplomas from when I attended the Police Youth Academy 5 years in a row. I have diplomas and I will show you guys. I'm cool with a whole lot of cops, bro. Like, I'm cool with a whole lot of cops. I was a whole court member for a youth court, helping youth expunge off their record the crimes that they did. Like, come on, like, youth court, like, I work with police. Like, this is nothing new to me. And we had a lot of events where, the events are called Bridging the Gap. And we had a lot of events where we did in the community centers, where it was basically the community youth got to sit down and talk to cops and really ask them, like, why are you killing us? Why are you doing this? Why are you doing that? And they were very blunt, like, cursing and all that. They understand our language, they understand our frustration. Trust me, it's not every cop, and I wanna get that out to y'all. It's not every cop, and it's very frustrating for the good cops to have to sit there and stand for something that they don't believe in. But because it's their job, it's their duty, they got to. So that's basically what the cops were saying during the Bridging the Gap events. And they understand that it takes one bad apple to represent the whole system. You feel me? Like, the whole other apples, it takes one bad apple. And the same goes for us. Like, y'all don't see how looting makes us look like savages and stuff like that. Like I said, if that's what you want to do, do it. You feel me? Whatever, no judgment. But you also got to consider the fact of how looting makes our apples look. Like savages, like animals. And the funny part is that we didn't even start the looting. Cops started the looting. White supremacists started the looting to continue to push the narrative of our people being savages and animals. It's sad. The world we live in is very sad. Like, so I understand both sides of the good apple cops. And I pray that the good apple cops that I know of are safe right now. And I know that they're outside patrolling and stuff. And I hope that they're safe, because they don't deserve it. And I don't know if y'all know it or not, they do stand up for us. Like, they stand up for the injustices. I've seen it. We can only do so much, especially in a force where it's like they're black and you may have a racist chief, your fellow partners at your station or at your precinct, my fool, maybe racist. So whatever you do could hurt your career. Niggas could just fire you. Like, you feel me? Like, it's not easy for them either. And it is a sad ass world that we live in, y'all. Honestly. Comment down below how y'all feel about what I'm saying. Y'all whole opinion about Black Lives Matter. And honestly, if you have a platform and you're not speaking or how you feel, I understand if you're not ready to, if you're not there yet, nobody's trying to push you. But if you do have something to say, say it and use your platform to say it. Spread your message, spread your thought. After quarantine, well, this may be after quarantine. This may come out after quarantine, honestly. So if it is after quarantine, I want you guys to comment down below. What's the first place y'all went to? What's the first thing y'all did? I saw something on Facebook about, oh, like I said, things may change because y'all seeing this in the future. But I saw something on Facebook like, oh, we're gonna have to be required to take the coronavirus antibody or whatever, shot or whatever. Like, what? Sweetheart, they said it don't matter if you object to taking it, you have to take it. Sweetie, I don't trust nothing that the government is trying to give us. Like, what? Are you dumb? You trying to inject me with something? Like, comment down below if y'all got y'all flu shot and comment why y'all got it, because I didn't get my flu shot. Like, what? I didn't get that. But I recommend if y'all doing crimps, put the hair, put the heat protector on your hair. I don't have any, so my favorite cop show is Law and Order. A lot of people try to say, oh, CSI, Lord. I fuck with Law and Order. Hard. I fuck with Blacklist too, but Law and Order got the cake. Like, what? Oh, some people may not know that my favorite movie is Twilight, and I heard that Shorty about to come out with a book. So I need to get that ASAP. Like, that'll be a perfect birthday present. And I fake love reading. I really, like, it depends. Like, we have a love-hate relationship. Like, I don't know. But yeah, I used to love reading though. I know that for a fact. And did y'all see George Floyd's daughter? She said, my daddy changed the world. Sweetheart, your daddy did. Like, your dad opened a lot of people's eyes. We've been seeing it. But we had enough. Tonight. But we've been seeing it though. Like, we've been seeing it with Trayvon. We've been seeing it with a lot of people. And we just had enough. Like, we've been had enough, but now, like, we are actually acting on our emotions. Like, this is crazy. And I want to shout out Kiki Palmer. I don't know if y'all saw that video, but she was over here she was like, march with us. Y'all know, like, that's the thing. Like, it's their job. Like, and it's sad that they, what is this piece? And it's sad, but it is their job. I'm going to fix that piece. They may not agree with it. They may not believe in what they're doing, but that's what they were ordered to do. That's the thing, when taking orders, you gotta do it whether you agree with it or not. Like, when they say that's an order, oh yeah. When they say 10 hut, that's an order. It's clip. Oh, I locked it. Turning it off. It's very hot, y'all. So I'm gonna spray my curls with the Got to Be. I'm gonna zoom in because what just dropped? Laced wheel. I'm not gonna even do that because I'm not no expert in hair, y'all. I just do what I have to living on a college campus where it's nothing but grass and cornfield. So you gotta do these things yourself. Definitely we'll be getting more press-ons, like, because the girl that I had to do my nails, she's not doing nails no more. So, and press-ons are just actually, like, they're cheaper, like, what, and they're cuter too. So let's see. But yeah, because I had this girl do my hair one time and she did a ponytail with my real hair, and it lasted an hour, not because of anything she did, but because I have really, really thick hair. So yeah, like, she straightened it and everything, and it was just clipped after that. Let me zoom out,
run my comb through it right quick so it could be more, a little bit puffy. Especially this part. Okay. Comment down below how y'all think I did. Comment down below if y'all want more hair videos. This is just a get ready with me chit chat during quarantine. About how I feel about Black Lives Matter. And I also really, really want to hear what you guys have to say, what you guys think about it. So yeah. Thank you guys for watching this video. This is the end. And cue the slow-mo. Mad annoying, but yeah, y'all, thank you guys for watching this video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Also follow my social media, it will be in the description down below. I really want you guys to comment down below how you guys feel about this Black Lives Matter thing, how you guys feel about quarantine. I just want to see where everybody's head is at, and make sure everybody is good, and make sure that everybody is fully aware of what's happening and why. So yeah, bye y'all, bye Sky Mob. That's what I'm gonna call y'all for now on, Sky Mob. I don't know if y'all caught on in my last video. I called you guys Sky Mob because that is the vibe. Period, y'all. Bye.